That is my wish. At the age of 18, so February 1994, I registered at UDW and received a bursary. March 94, my parents found out that I was pregnant. May 94, I got married. June of the same year, I had my son. December of the same year, I was separated. So for my 19th birthday, I found myself alone, unemployed, to a mother of a six-month-old son. At this point, there was no reason for me to even do anything or pursue any dreams. All the dreams, all the aspirations were locked up and the key was thrown away. My only thought then was to provide for my son. And I got a job as a desk clerk. And I worked as a desk clerk for 14 years. But I do believe that they are superheroes. And I happened to meet one of those. He's my superman. My courageous husband, Sada, who, knowing what my past was, took me in, loved me and my son like we were his own. I now have two more kids. And I worked at the desk clerk, miserable as hell, collecting money for some guy. I had no joy in my life. I had no peace in my life. I had no understanding of why my life turned out the way it did. And it sucked. In my 30s, I now had three kids. I'm still a desk clerk. And I was miserable. But not just miserable. I hated everything about myself. See, I didn't understand a single thing about grooming. I didn't understand that I was groomed for the abuse. I just believed that maybe in another lifetime I had done something really horrible and that I deserved this. I believed that I deserved the abuse. I believed that I didn't deserve to qualify and get a degree in anything. And I hated myself. Like, I couldn't stand even looking at myself in the mirror. And my sister began studying to become a life coach. And she would call me every day and remind me, because I'm doing what I'm doing. I came up with something called a tour around the world where I used six different accents and I sang in different languages when I was 12. So what you see me do now, I've been doing all my life. But when things crumbled around me, I shelved it. And my sister would call me every day and remind me about who I was. Because I needed someone to remind me, because I couldn't see my light, I couldn't see my work, I didn't believe I deserved anything. And with her coaching, she helped me to see that I'm not a bad person, that I'm actually a victim. Because I saw myself as someone who allowed it to happen, but it started when I was 4 and a half and I had no control over it. But I didn't understand that. I blamed myself. And after years of understanding how life works, how our minds work, and how to see myself in a different light, and from reading the book that Ashika is going to talk to you about today, because in my 30s I found myself with arthritis and cataracts. That's an old lady's disease, arthritis and cataracts in my 30s. I've since, reading the book, been able to cure myself of arthritis. I've liberated myself from hating myself. I see my light. I see my talents. I see the love that I have to give as a beacon of light for other women to also follow suit. To see yourself is a very difficult thing, because every single person that you encounter has an opinion of you in their minds. And there's very little you can do to convince people that you are a certain way. So I had to convince myself that I was not a bad, horrible person, that I deserved to give myself a chance, and that's what I did. I started to see myself. I started to recognize my light. I started to love myself. I went from hating and loathing myself. loving mother. Hence, Analakshmi was born when I grieved and I was retrenched in 2011 and I decided I am not going back to be a debtor's clerk. I believe that I belong on the stage. I put an ad on Gumtree. I said emceeing and entertainment and comedy skits. And I started going out and entertaining people. And slowly but surely within the Satya organization, so spirituality played a huge role in helping uplift myself. Because Satya Sai Baba refers to devotees as Prema Swarupalala, which means an embodiment of love. And at the time I thought there were a few people who were selected to be in this organization and they were embodiments of love. I now know that every single one of us here is an embodiment of love. We were born out of love. We were born for the sake of love. And love is truly the only thing that you can give that is completely of yourself. That is love. That's what life is all about. It's about love. So